young and do it all for the G. I gotta keep in mind that relatives of mine is trying to build like me. Sit down with G-Connect, gotta think. Every moment got you tapping the mental and looking out for the key. As a young and do it all for the G. I gotta keep in mind that relatives of mine is trying to build like me. Sit down with G-Connect, gotta think. Every moment got you tapping the mental and looking out.
Check this out. GLA double dollar sign east side. That's right. Glasses Malone. And you already know you tapping in. G-Connect, nigga. G-Connect.
What's happening though, man? It's Mr. Ben Ben Bracken, Fig Newton, representing this fast lane shit. I'm letting y'all know to go tap in with the homie G2B's, Bill Blast over there with that G-Connect show. Generation Conversation. Good game, good feed. Go on over there and get your belly fed. Yeah, most of all, like, comment, and subscribe. Let the homie know I sent you. Whoa, whoa.
Clack, clack. What's happening, y'all? This your boy, Mitchie Slick. I'm here with the homeboy D and the homie G2B's. Yeah, yeah, we keeping it all the way gangster on the G-Connect show. Act like you know, homie. If you ain't fuck with them, I ain't fucking with you. Yeah, that. Straight out of Southeast Dago. Logan Ann. Clack, clack.
Welcome back as we continue this conversation with the one and only King Tech TV. Like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. You feel me?
It was like a 10-year gap of not making shit, and then I come back one day, I decide to make a video for my kids, redoing a Billie Eilish song, and I used the zipper on my sweater to create it just to be like funny and clever. They loved it. I posted it to Facebook. It blew up. I loved how it felt, to be honest. It like brought me out of this darkness. People were saying how good it was, so I couldn't wait to make the next one. So I make another one, and eventually, you know, after a few months, people tell me go to Instagram. I do that. And that's where it just really started to explode in me networking and meeting all these people that I've met, is because of as soon as I touched Instagram. I met two individuals really that I'd say are solely responsible for a majority of my network, you know?
Okay. Yeah, that's understandable. So what do you classify what you do on there? Podcasting, media, blogging?
Man, it's really changed because I started Instagram as a musician, as a producer. Like, let me show you what I can do. I can make the beats live on the spot. I can play guitar. I can implement them all into a track. And that's how it started. But I started meeting a certain EA Ski, one of the first producers I met. Super producer Rhythm D, Miko Wu, Capadonna. These are certain individuals, Maya Lansky from Wu Syndicate, certain individuals who reached out to me on the side at my beginning stages when I had, you know, 4,000 followers, but they saw the video and they loved it. And it was like, it was like just getting that type of feedback from them got me so excited about what I'm doing that one day I invited a guy on live and he came on and I'm just chopping it up with him. But it's like, okay, for example, Chris Glove, it's a legend, super producer, Chris Glove. So I'm on my drum machine making a beat. He joins my live and I'm like, what the I can't believe this dude's here. I'm like giddy like a little fucking kid. Like, dude, you made Explosive. You made Phone Tap with Nas. You're, dude, Reckless Ice-T. You're a super producer. And he's buying me badges and shit. Well, he comes on. We're chopping it up. Then I met this gentleman, Roach Killer, Dismos, all these guys. But what I kept getting, I would used to get 4,000 messages a day, man, where people were saying, we love your energy. We love how you talk to when you engage, your engagement with, like, Dismos. And that's what started our show was Dismos came on my live just to tell me he liked my beats, and we'd be joking back and forth, and people loved it. They loved how me and him, we think very similar, both Virgos. I mean, we think exactly the same, but we come from wildly different parts of the world, you know, it's like different walks of life. And I think that's what really makes this work is, Dismos, I mean, to put it simply, from my followers or fans, they would say Dismos is the street cat. He has Mount Hoodmore tattooed across his chest, and I would be like the geek, the computer nerd. So it was like, for us to somehow be able to have a conversation, get along, laugh, and joke about the same shit, They loved it. They love that we can connect like that. And I got a lot of messages, people saying like they like that I can network and mingle within this crowd without changing who I am. I don't have to all of a sudden, you know what I'm saying, son? Like start talking different and shit. I'm just going to be myself. You know what I'm saying? I'm just going to be myself, and it worked out. So I don't know what to classify it as, my long roundabout answer. I don't know. I was a musician, producer. All I get every day are messages, people saying they love my energy when I interview people. So it turned into this interviewing show, which is turning into a podcast. I have a podcast coming out with Tash from the Alcoholics. It's turning into a bunch of shit, but I don't know. I'm a Renaissance man. I could play 14 different instruments. I could rap. I can produce. I can act. I can dance. I can interview. I don't know what it is, but I do a little bit of all.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. Are you currently working on any new projects today?
Yes. So right now we have it is somewhat secretive. So I had a thing called the Ultimate Producer Beat Battle. I started it with that. So basically, I would get about 150 to 200 songs a day sent to me from producers, rappers, singers, songwriters. I started noticing, you know, 80% of producers all made trap and they all sounded the same. This is just what I'm being sent, okay? Not everyone, but I'm saying if out of 100 producers, 80 of them all sent me trap and they all use the same sound, same hi-hat, same fucking song over and over and over. But then there was 20 left that were so incredibly talented that I was shocked and I thought, you know what? I have a huge network of celebrities, famous, well-known, influential musicians, singer, MCs, producers in my network. So I'm going to throw a competition. So what I did was a producer beat battle, 4 different rounds, 4 different categories, some sample flip challenges. Basically, we'd have an anonymous judging. They'd play their beat. I'd have all kinds of celebrity, 8 celebrity guest judges each episode. We'd pick a winner of that. That winner would move on. We'd go to the grand championship to find that one producer that can make anything. We got him. That's JL Beats. I manage him. We did that with MCs. We did that with singers. What I'm doing, though, is getting the best of the best of each category. We've created multiple songs. Not only that, I'm working with my celebrity guest judges. They want to be part of this project. Now, I see it as a win-win for everybody. I have a large following and a large platform with people like Ag, JD, The Chill, Chris Glove. They all have Tony Hasbun. They have music coming out. So they have invested interest in their own project. But if they're working with me on a large platform, I win because I get to use these big names. They win because I have the platform. They win for album sales. I win for album sales. Producer wins. He now has a resume that says these influential names. Yes. Everybody involved wins.
It worked.
So that's what I'm working on now. We have an incredible project with some incredible names. Chip Fu, legend, Brother Jay. Mad Lion, Rufus Black, Rhythm D, Roach Killer, Dismos, The Chill, Miss Toy, Aguilar, Tara Van, Lena Kane. It's going to be, Bizarre, Foul Mouth. It's going to be ridiculous. Yuck Mouth. We got some heavy hitters.
Okay. My guy, Yuck Mouth.
Yeah.
I know a few of those names you named personally, too. Yeah. And I look forward to that. I look forward to seeing that, Blossom Mountain turn into what it's going to turn into.
Yep.
If you enjoyed the content and the conversation with King Tech TV, continue watching the rest of the episodes. You feel me? Only on G Connect.
G2B, the generation conversation. You ain't got the patience. Get on.